Hello guys, welcome to Code with PK. So in this video, I'm going to solve question 9 of IC 2019 Computer Science Theory paper. So it says a class rearrange has been defined to modify a word by bringing all the vowels in the word at the beginning followed by the consonants. Okay. So example, original is the word. So all the vowels, for example, O, I, I becomes okay. Okay. Some of the members of the class are given below. Word, new word. Okay. So private data members are word and new word, and then rearrange, which is default constructor. Name of the class is rearrange. There is void read word to accept the word in uppercase. Okay. And then you have void frequency word vowel consonants. Find the frequency of vowels and consonants in the word and displace them with an appropriate message. Okay. Okay. Arranges the word by the bringing vowels in the following conjunction, displays the original word along with the rearranged word. Okay, the requirements are pretty clear. Let's see the last part. Specify the class rearrange, giving the details of the constructor, void read word, word frequency, and define the main function to create an object and call the functions accordingly to enable the task. Okay, so I'm going to start writing this class. Oops, not here. Also, I am writing it on an editor, right? And you will be writing it on a piece of paper. So you'll have to plan out a little. So you should be writing one function after the other, and you should give yourself maximum space possible so that when you have to come back and maybe edit a few things, you don't have any shortage of spaces. I'll start with class rearrange. Okay. The private data members I have. So I have word and new word. So private string WRD and private string new WRD. So I always tell you to keep your private instance, the name of the private instance members, the name of methods exactly as given in the question. So you see WRD is my name of the word and new WRD is the name of the rearranged word. Okay, and then I start with the member functions and constructors. So I always tell you that keep the constructors and member functions as public. So the constructor, okay, so public rearrange, and okay, this default structure does nothing. Okay, and then you have, so word and new word are not supposed to be initialized here, so nothing to be done. Then you have to read a word, public void read word. Okay, again keeping the name of the method exactly the same as given the question, read word, to accept the word in uppercase. Since no parameter is passed to this method, so I assume that I'll have to open a scanner here. Okay, so import java dot ut dot scanner. Okay, open a scanner here and then create a scanner object and read the word. So scanner equals to new scanner system dot in. Okay, ask for the word. So system dot out dot println, print enter a word. Okay, so now you have two options to use with scanner here. One is next and one is next line. With next line, you can and it will take multiple words till the change in line, but with next it will just take a single word. Okay, so I'm going to use next and not next line, because even when if the user is adding multiple words to the input, my program will read only one word. Okay, so I have WRD is equals to scanner dot next. Read word is all words that this was supposed to do. I close the scanner. Scanner dot close. Okay. Next method is freq vowel and consonants. To find the frequency of vowels and consonants. Okay. Void freq vowel con and takes nothing, and this has to be public. Okay, so finds the frequency of vowels and consonants in the word and displays them with an appropriate message. Okay, So it says accept the word in an uppercase, but it nowhere says that you have to check for uppercase. So if you want, when you are using this, so you can check for uppercase here. You can iterate the length of this word and check if each character is in uppercase or not. Okay. If it is not the case, then you can say to the user that you have entered a word which is not all in uppercase. So maybe you should enter another word. Okay. So, but I'm not adding that because assuming that the user will enter the uppercase word here. Okay. So we have to complete this, find the frequency of vowel and consonant. So to count the vowels. So int vowels we count equals to 0, int c count to count the consonant is equals to 0. Okay. Now there's another thing you need to consider. Iterate to the length gth of the sentence. Okay. So in order to check for a vowel, you can add a private method. Okay. But I'm not going to add because I'm going to confer to whatever they're asking me to write. I'm not going to add a private method. There's nowhere that this says that you can add private method or not. So I say that you can ask your tutor or your teacher or your instructor, whoever is teaching you, that you are allowed to add private methods in such cases or not. Okay. Because I will have to check for vowels in a couple of cases, in arrange method and in frequency, freak, wow, con method. Okay. So rather than I write the same code twice, I can add a method. So you can confirm with this here teacher. Okay. So iterate to the length of the sentence. So for int I is equal to 0, I is less than wrd.length, I plus plus. Okay. If this is a vowel. Okay. So how do you check for vowel? I am going to use a simple fall through switch case. So wrd.charAt. I okay, and for case A again, now if you assume that letter is accepted in uppercase, so you don't have to check for lowercase, and I will not be checking for lowercase because the word has to be in uppercase. So A E I O and U, for all these cases I increment we count. Okay. We count plus plus. So vowel count is equals to vowel count plus 1. Okay. And a flag to check if it is a vowel. Okay. So boolean is vowel equals to false and is vowel right after this case is set to true. Okay, so if this is not a vowel, increment consonant count. Okay, if not vowel, so c count is equals to c count plus 1. Okay. Okay, this another thing that you can really consider is what about those characters which are neither vowels nor consonant, that is digits or things like that. So even if there is a digit, right? So if there is a digit, so this will be set to false. So for a digit, none of this will be true. So this V count will not be incremented. Is vowel will remain false. And since is vowel remain false, so C count will also not be incremented. So for digits and for all those characters which are neither vowels nor consonants, okay, so the count of vowels and consonant won't be affected. Okay, so then display a message. Okay, now as I told you, I'm not adding anything for the lowercase because the sentence has to be, the word has to be in uppercase. Okay, uppercase only it said, right? Uppercase. So system dot out dot println, oops, println number of vowels. Okay, plus we count and I similarly number of consonants. Okay, I shift this so as to look neat. C count. Okay, this method is done. Moving on to the next part, which is arrange. So public void arrange. Okay, so I can retype, but I'm going to copy this part, okay? So the string to store the rearranged, okay? So WRD, so what you can do here is you can set WRD to blank, okay, and you can set new word to blank as well, okay? So when we have to rearrange, we don't have to set the new word again, okay? Iterate for int I is equal to 0, I is less than wrd.length I plus plus, okay? So if this is a vowel, okay, I just copied the code, you can rewrite it. So if this is a vowel, I add it to the add it to the word first. So new WRD plus is equals to, because new WRD, plus is equals to word dot caret I. Okay, so iterate the length of the string and add the vowels first, okay? Then iterate the length of the string, or you can do in another way, you can say to store vowels. So in this case we need just one for loop. So string vowels is equals to blank, string consonants is equals to blank, okay? And I use the same idea of a flag, okay? So I can copy this whole thing, okay. So I don't have this V count here, but what I do is I set vowels is equals to vowels plus word dot caret I, okay? And if this is not a vowel, I say consonants is equals to consonants plus word dot caret I, okay? So I have consonants in one string and I have vowels in another string, and concatenate and store in new WRD. So new WRD is equals to vowels plus consonants. And consonants, okay? Vowels and vowels, okay? And display. So system dot out dot println rearranged form of plus WRD plus is, okay, plus new WRD, okay, because I'm trying to show that this is the rearranged form of this. Or do I need to display in the next one? I need to display in the next one to display, okay? So public void display, okay, and I have this here, okay? I'm copy pasting because I'm on an editor, you cannot, because you will be on a piece of paper and pen, okay? So yeah, so I'll write rearrange form is simply, and I'll write original word is, WRD, and rearranged word is new WRD, okay? That is what display is supposed to do, right? Displays the original word along with rearranged word, okay? Rearrange the word by, okay? Okay, so I am done. I'm just going to add the main. So the main method, so public static void main string args, okay? Create an object. So I create rearrange equals to new rearrange There is nothing to be passed in the constructor, I believe. Okay, and then rearrange dot accept word, right? Read word, right? So it reads words first, then rearrange dot frequency of vowel and consonants, then rearrange dot arrange, and then rearrange dot display. Okay, so I guess it's all done. Let me just give it a quick check. Class rearrange private string word, pressing new WRD, new WRD. Okay, and I have word equals to blank, new WRD is equals to blank. Read word scanner scanner dot system dot in scanner dot next will give me a word. Okay, scanner dot close public void freak word count. Okay, we count c count word dot length I plus plus is always false word dot caret I e e I u for all this. We count is we count plus one and is vowel equals to true. Okay, and then I have if this is not is vowel, c count plus one. Okay, it's not a number of vowels, we count number of consonants, c count vowels consonants word dot length. Okay, consonants plus caret. Okay, vowels plus consonant. Okay, read word. Okay, so let me just compile and check. I hope there is no compilation error. Okay, so no compilation error, I'm glad. Enter a word, original. Number of vowels are 4, O-I-I-A. Okay, number of consonants are 4, original word is original, so O-I-I-A-R-G-N-L. So my code just works fine. Let us work for another case is code with BK. Oh, all in caps. Code with BK. So O E I with then all the consonants. And as I told you, if you enter multiple words, hello, how, okay, hello, hi, how. So it will just read hello. Okay, because it is supposed to read a word. Had you used a next line, so this all would have gone inside, which would not be a correct case because we are taking one single word. So it has E and O in this order and then each have H, L, L. So the code worked just fine. So I hope this video was helpful. So please do like this video and subscribe to my channel for more such videos. And thank you for watching.